Hey everyone, welcome to the third video of our introductory series of Apollo Server and how you can host your GraphQL Server in Azure. My name is Michael Watson, and in this video, we're going to take the project that we had previously built and hosted inside of an Azure App Service, and we're going to host that inside of an Azure Function using VS Code and the VS Code Azure Function extension. Let's check it out. Now we have just the simple server index file brought over from our previous project, but we're going to need to initialize our Azure Functions project using that VS Code extension. We're going to use TypeScript, and we're going to need to create an HTTP trigger for our GraphQL endpoint. Now from there, we're going to be able to just copy and paste all of our code into that Azure Functions trigger that was just created for us. Now we're also going to need to install the necessary packages, GraphQL, and this time instead of just Apollo Server, it's going to be Apollo Server with Azure Functions. This is going to have the Azure Functions handler that we're going to need. Now that we have the package installed, instead of having our server listen, we're actually going to export out that handler I was mentioning. Now from here, the last thing we're going to need to do is we're going to want to have GraphQL playground return in this function. So we're going to need to change in our function.json to actually return out resources. Now, one of the really nice benefits of this is using that extension, it's automatically going to create the configuration options for us to debug our project. So we can simply just press the play button and we'll be able to start debugging that GraphQL server just like we were inside the app service. Now I can go to that URL. I still have my GraphQL playground. And you can see that that debugging experience works as expected. Now, one of the problems I don't like is I have this like slash API, and I want to remove that. I just want to be slash GraphQL. That's pretty common for our GraphQL servers. Well, we can change that by changing the host in Azure Functions. We'll need to exchange the actual extensions to go down to the HTTP level and change that route prefix. Once we've done that, we'll be able to start our server up and actually have it be that slash GraphQL. But before we do that, let's actually just push this into Azure. Now, we can simply just create a new Azure App Service function. We'll give it a name. To pick where we want to deploy it, and it's going to create that resource and deploy that out. We can monitor the output, of course, in the Output tab if we go into the Azure Function extension. Now that our deployment is successful, we can actually go up and go into that URL and visit GraphQL Playground running in our Azure function. And of course, we can still write our queries right here in Playground, just as we have this whole time. Now, just like with an Azure App Service, it's very easy for us to come in here and start streaming logs, maybe deploying it, or maybe configuring out some application settings. The benefit of using this extension is we have a lot of control, and really, at its core level, you can start up a GraphQL server project and really get something cool out the door in less than a day using Azure Functions. I think it's a really great tool for you to use in your GraphQL development. Now that we've taken our basic GraphQL server and hosted it inside of an Azure function, we've seen how we can take an Apollo Server instance and host in either an Azure App Service or an Azure Function. If you enjoyed these videos, please leave comments and feedback within Channel 9. I'd love to come back and do more videos to show a federated GraphQL server inside of Azure. It's a lot of fun stuff. Thanks for having me.